Well, we'll see.
Okay.
I think we're ready. And no one in front. So car masses are probably the most safe. So who knows, we might move out here one day. God willing, if that doesn't happen with the COVID-19. But it's beautiful that we can do this and that technology can let it happen. And currently Facebook Live is working too. So we have some people on Facebook. I like how some are strategically out of the camera. Let us go ahead and begin. I hope everybody knows 89.7 for the for everyone at the cemetery and around the cemetery. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Thank you. our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for our reading.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
For your sake, I bear myself. Shame covers my face. I have become an outcast to my brothers, a stranger to my mother's children, because you, for your help, persecute me, and the insults of those who blaspheme you fall upon me.
Lord, love, answer me.
I pray to you, O Lord, for the time of your favor, O God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus said to the 12, "Fear no one. Nothing is concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. What I say to you in the darkness, speak in the light. What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, you see, today is the feast of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, and the first reading comes from the prophet Jeremiah. And Jeremiah was given a difficult task.
God told him, go and tell the people.
If they keep going down this road, bad things are going to happen. If they keep worshiping others, come back. And instead of them listening, they attack. Instead of them listening, they attack. Instead of listening, they attack. And yet today, in our country, we can hear the great fear that is in his heart. Terror on every side, denounce, let us denounce him. All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. But then his tone changes. And he says, but the Lord is with me. Like a mighty champion, my persecutors will stumble. They will not triumph. In other words, his faith was in God. It wasn't about getting happiness from the people that he was helping. It was simply that God asked him to do it, and God knew what he was going through.
Now, my background is in medicine. It is in biomedical engineering. So,
if you look at the body, the skeleton holds it up. Without the skeleton, of course, just the skeleton can't do much. But the skeleton, just like a tent with the center pole, gives the stability. Our foundation has to be in God. Our love and our belief has to come first. That's where we get our stability. And then we help our families. Then we help our world. Because our families and our world won't always appreciate what might not end here but have eternal life. Here is not the end. And so it's good news for us that when our loved ones are close to God, because then they're invincible. Then God is taking care of them. Foundation that we'll never be afraid. And I'm going to end with the joke. There was once a hunter that was out looking for deer. And lo and behold, he comes around a pass
and there's
a big old grizzly bear. He goes down
and starts to pray. And the bear prays, bless us, O Lord, and leave thy gifts that we are about to receive. But the good news of that joke, again, is when you hold on to God,
you really are invincible. This world is not the end. This world is only to get us to the next. And when your soul is intact, again, be not afraid of the person or the bear that takes your body. Be afraid of the one that can take your soul in your body. If your soul is sound, are persecuted for their faith may grow in courage to acknowledge Christ in the presence of others. We pray to the Lord. That the sick may be healed, the dying consoled, and the departed welcomed into eternal life. We pray to the Lord. For the intention of this Mass, the St. Mary's Cemetery, blessings on these with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the church, and the entire people you have made.
Thank you.
we now can receive communion on the tongue. The bishop had been wanting us to only receive in the hand. Again, it's recommended to receive in the hand, but for those that would like it on the tongue, it's now allowed again. In the coming weeks, there's a few other things that will get a little bit more back to normal. Maybe by next weekend, we might start having the communion line again. I'm hoping in about four weeks, we'll start up adoration again. I'll be calling our doors. But we're slowly moving back to the normal, but a bit of a new normal, because we'll always be a little bit, the hand sanitizer isn't going anywhere. The mass online is not going anywhere. And at this time, there still is, it's still not required to go to Sunday Mass. The bishop still has, what's it called, the dispensation in place, but he wants us, if we're not elderly or have health problems, we want everyone to slowly get back to Mass. Even if you're just watching, because it's the Mass that makes our Sunday holy, that includes God in our Sunday. Saturday evening is part of Sunday. So, the Star Quilt now has a date. We're going to have the Star Quilt wrap on August 9th. So we're giving Betty all of July. Please stand. let me know in the next 5 minutes before Journey is done with me, because he's going to take the extra host back to the church. And thank you all for coming.
Camera here.
Oh, are y'all blocking someone in?
Yeah.